हॅलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू अवर चॅनल. फ्रेंड्स, आज आपण इंग्लिश शॉर्ट हँडमध्ये 130 WPM डिक्टेशन पॅरा बघूया. सो फ्रेंड, हा व्हिडिओ पूर्ण बघा, लाईक शेअर आणि कमेंट करा आणि सबस्क्राईब करायला अजिबात विसरू नका. सो फ्रेंड, डिक्टेशन स्टार्ट करूया. सम पीपल व्हायलेंटली कॅरीड अवे बाय देअर ॲडमिरेशन ऑफ द ग्रेट वर्क दॅट मनी does for the community, fall unconsciously into a very natural error. They begin to confuse the money with the things money will buy. Money, of course, simply implies a right to draw goods from the market, but these more money enthusiasts seem to think that an increase in money means an automatic increase in the bread and boats and beef offered for sale. A little thought should be enough to dispel that illusion. Increase in the number of pieces of money no more increases the real means of enjoyment than an increase in the number of theaters tickets increases the accommodation in the theater. If prices go up, this signifies that money is being produced at a greater rate than the goods for which it will exchange. There is, people say, inflation. When prices go down, the money is being produced at a less rate than the goods for which it will exchange. There is then inflation. In either event, there will be an upsetting of the big bargains that have already been made. You and I sell our services for money, and we do this in the confident expectations that the money will provide us with the things we really want. If the price we could get for the services always varied with the prices of goods in the market, we should have nothing to complain of. But things do not happen so, and there is quite unwarranted revision of the contract we have made. Some of us have bargained for a long while ahead in terms of money. If the money diminishes in purchasing power, we are robbed of some of our legitimate expectations. True, prices may go down, our unity of the money may exercise a greater pull over the market, in that we are getting more real goods than we were entitled to accept. For myself, though, I should, in a matter of as great importance, prefer certainty to chance. I dare say I am prejudiced in a matter, for I am one of the people who have sold services a long while ahead for my whole life. In fact, if we take into account pension payment also, from the selfish point of view, I should welcome falling prices, for then the money counters handed to me will enable me to get more of the good thing, soul of life. If the fall in prices results from the man over the nature, so much the better. I am then simply sharing in the general advance. If, however, the fall is due to causes that have not increased the supply of goods, I am gaining at the expenses of these whose income depends more immediately upon prices. For instance, the grocer selling his wares alter what he sell his services for as prices rise or fail. It is the businessman and the manufacturer, therefore, who are the most greatly advantaged by the steady rising prices. The business community get the great incentive, for they get the first advantage in the form of higher and highest profit. Thank you.